Hey, Sashan, what's going on?
Well, 3 weeks ago, I ordered a book, a thick book from Amazon. This one here, it's not going to focus, but who knows? It's the best book I've ever seen in my entire life for PyQt 5 GUI programming. Now, it's written for Python. So there's no Python knowledge or learning in this book. None. You have to already know Python. Not by heart, but you need to know at least, I want to say, you want to be good with about 40 to 50% of Python to use this book. And, 40% is your basic. Know at least half of the Python commands, and you're able to do basic computer algorithms. Searches, lists, alphabetizings, add, deletes, edits, in other words, printing. Your basic computer stuff. That's like 40, 50% of the language. I ordered this book 3 weeks ago. I guess it was printed on demand. A week later, it was shipped to me from Las Vegas. I finished reading it the other day. Every day I was reading two or three chapters when I got home from work. And I tried the examples in the book, and all the examples you can download from the guy's website, Martin Fitzpatrick. I'll put a link below. He's been updating this book for years. It seems like every 2 months or so, there's a new version. This book was made, what, just a few months ago? Edit-wise. But I noticed on the website, there's a newer version of the book on his website. He had a little blurb saying, hey, if you bought my book recently, let me know, and I'll sign you up for access to the free downloads. So I did. Yesterday, I emailed him and got a response back. So I downloaded the new versions, new editions on PDF and everything. But there's not much changes. There's some bugs. There's some bugs in this book. But if you know Python, you can fix the bugs. They're minor. They're just minor things. Copy paste issues, that kind of thing. I want to say Martin's. Well, he had collaborators with him, so I want to say English is not their first language. So as I was reading this book, I noticed certain chapters had wonderful English. Some chapters were bad English. sentences missing periods and commas and capitalized letters at the beginnings of sentences. But my lizard brain would just auto-correct what I was reading. So it wasn't that big of a deal. On the programming, and that's more important. The programs are top-notch in general. They're no typos. English was the first language for whoever was typing in the programs. And so I would just, half the time I'd either type the program in from the book. The print is big, because my eyeballs are so bad these days. I'm in my 50s, so, eyeballs. The print is big, so I didn't have to squint or nothing while reading the book. And I had the book in my lap, and I'm typing away. And then sometimes I would just go on the website, and if it was too long or too dense of machine code type stuff, I would just go and copy-paste it from his website into my notepad. I use Notepad for about 80% of the projects. Notepad Plus, was it Notepad Plus Plus? That's my go-to editor for programming in. But once in a blue moon, I'd go into the Microsoft Visual Code and use that. But that one I use for, big heavy-duty projects I'm working on, especially for the computer here. But if it's just a little one page blurb from the book, sample, here, type these 10 or 12 lines in and watch it go. Then I would just use Notepad++ to type it in. And what else? So basically, so what is QT Pi? Or was what is it called? PyQt? What is PyQt 5, you ask, at the beginning of this video? It's a library written in C that's been wrapped with Python code so that Python programmers can use this C GUI that C programmers have been using without issue. Now Python programmers can use it without issue. And I guess PyQt 6 is just around the corner. They've been, the QT 6 people have been releasing QT 6 for a year now in bits and pieces. It's not fully there yet. It's not fully supported. It's still an experiment. But I got those files anyway from Martin. So I might look at it. I don't know. I used PyQt 4 for 10 years. And I just recently started using PyQt 5 because that's what the new version of Python uses. Oh, another thing, this book mentions it's the graph one. What is it called? I want to say it's PyQt graph. It covers matplotlib. Yeah, it's called PyQt graph, which I'd never heard of until I bought this book. And PyQt graph is using, it uses itself, and then it uses OpenGL, or Pi, was it Pi OpenGL for 3D graphics? So I was playing around with that. Because I'm getting ready to rewrite some old Traveler code that I've got that used Pygame graphics. And if I can do it in like an OpenGL kind of a thing, that would be cool. Just, you know, planets with spaceships doing orbits and things, and, you know, little space colony type stuff, out like outpost colony type things. Just for graphic, you know, just for background noise when I'm running my Traveler games and stuff. I got like little things off to the side on the computer I can just click on, because it's a world. It's a world that runs, you know, I'll save that for another video. But anyway, it was neat that PyQt graph is in this, and it runs so much faster than matplotlib does. But matplotlib does a lot more than PyQt graph. Anyway, I wasn't expecting those things to even be in this book. I just wanted to buy a book. Look how thick this book is. It's like, how many pages is this thing? This page is 714 pages. It has an index. And the index is good. It works. And lots of examples. Lots of modern day type apps that you would use for Python. And anyway, the guy's blog site, he's got blogs posted on other projects for Python and articles, and there's courses you can sign up for and take those courses, you know, video courses, that kind of thing. So Martin's got a good setup on his website. Anyway, enough yapping about it. I'm going to toss a bunch of Python books that I don't need anymore because they're obsolete now that I've got this book, and make more room on my bookshelves, because I want to replace these Python books here. These are all from Python 2.5. And maybe I can make some more room for Traveler books. I have Traveler books starting to pile up on my floor. I don't have room. I don't have enough bookcases anymore, I guess, for my role-playing game. Anyway, I'll let you guys go. Talk to you later.